Usually I take the first few seconds of my videos to provide some background for the weird corners of the internet that I'm going to be exploring that day, but I'm in an awkward position because CNN, NBC, and just about every other major news outlet in the world has already kind of done that for me. Let's give it a shot anyways. Biz is a message board on 4chan.org dedicated to business and finance, but has over time become mostly focused on the discussion of the stock market. Similarly, our Wall Street Bets is a community within Reddit also focused on stock market. And there's basically so much overlap between the two communities that at this point I'm just going to refer to them both as Biz. And for those of you coming from 4chan, I'll go ahead and give you 10 seconds to call me a Redditor in the comments. Feel better? Good. You guys do know that you basically are Reddit at this point. Like, there's so much overlap, and you guys have so many new people coming in that you're, like, probably 90% Reddit at this point. You need to leave another comment? Okay. All right, we're going to go ahead. Biz, like any other long-standing community on the internet, has developed its own unique culture that exists outside of the subject matter that they're supposed to be discussing. There are countless communities online that are dedicated to seriously discussing the stock market, but Biz is mostly dedicated to shitposting. If you don't know what shitposting is, the best I can give you in 10 seconds is that it's a type of humor that's pretty nihilistic, that's basically doing stupid things purely for the sake of entertaining yourself and maybe others. The way this manifests in Biz is people throwing money at stupid things in stupid ways, sometimes making a lot of money, but most of the time just losing a lot of money. For instance, one user going by the name of Deep Fucking Value became obsessed with the stock market in GameStop, the video game retail store. He might have been doing this because of all the memes centered around the retailer, or maybe he just legitimately liked the place and wanted to see it succeed. Maybe he just saw something that no one else did. And in fact, it was that last thing, because he actually recognized that a hedge fund for billionaires was manipulating the stock market in such a way that, you know what, I'm not even gonna bother trying to explain this part. There's like 20,000 other good explanations out there, so I'll just leave that to you, because like a majority of Biz, I pretty much know nothing about the stock market. Let's suffice it to say that Reddit and 4chan noticed a bunch of billionaires were trying to sabotage GameStop to make a profit, and in doing so, expose themselves to a tremendous risk that, well, it looks like the whole internet is taking advantage of right now. As I'm making this video, the situation is still playing out, but it looks like the internet just trolled a bunch of billionaires out of a lot of money. We'll see. What I do know is that I basically predicted this a few months ago. I'll confess I didn't really see it going this way, but basically since the pandemic first broke out, I recognized that a lot of people were being forced to stay at home and communicate entirely with the internet. And I basically called it. We're going into a new era of the internet. What I didn't predict was a bunch of people effectively burning stimulus checks in order to make billionaires cry. What's becoming apparent with this situation and the QAnon-inspired raid on the US Capitol earlier this month is that the more time people are spending on the internet, the more the internet is becoming a part of the real world. I see a lot of mainstream media trying to lump these two events, these two groups of people, as if they're coming from the same place, but you only need to spend a little bit of time with either of these communities to recognize that any similarities they share are pretty skin deep, with the exception that both communities have an extreme distrust of billionaires, but that's becoming a pretty popular attitude these days, isn't it? But see, to boomers, the older generation, the people who aren't spending a lot of time online, the people who aren't constantly interacting with strangers from all over the world, it seems like these people are coming out of nowhere, that this is some kind of new radical populist movement that's been expertly organized and deployed. But anyone who's even just mildly literate in internet culture knows exactly what this is. It's a raid. 4chan was doing this to Habbo Hotel in 2006, and now, well, they're raiding reality. Let's keep an eye on the situation as it continues to develop, and I'll check back in with you all later. Have a good evening, Netscape Navigators.